You're listening to the audio production of Who Are You Following? Guided Journal by Sadie Robertson Huff, published by Thomas Nelson and read by Hayley Cresswell.
Introduction. Hey friends, welcome to our journal. I say our journal because it is one that you and I get to share together. I wanted to create a beautiful space for us to reflect on who we are and who we want to be. Because this is a journal, I guess I need to be as open with you as I can be. So why don't I just start off with a bang? I have struggled with anxiety, insecurity, comparison, jealousy, and perfectionism. And although I might have once assumed that saying those things would shock you, I bet it doesn't surprise you at all, does it? Because don't most of us struggle with those things at some point or another? I will never forget sitting in a meeting at a college with the presidents of every sorority as girl after girl admitted her struggles with all these things. As I sat and pondered the idea that each of us struggled with such similar challenges, I began to wonder why. Why are we all getting these results at the end of the day? And I wondered, does it actually have to be this way? After prayer and some ups and downs myself, I can more clearly see why we may all be in this same toxic pattern. I'll go ahead and answer those questions for you because I don't want you to go another second without knowing the answers I found to be true. Why are we getting these results? I would say it's almost as if we are all following the same cheat sheet that the world handed us for the test of life. But the world got the answers one bubble off. We are all searching for the same things: peace, freedom, joy, contentment, confidence, truth, and love. But we are finding anxiety, depression, insecurity, comparison, jealousy, lust, confusion, and more. And it's because of who and what we are following, a cheat sheet that is a bubble off. I finally reached a point where I said, enough is enough. I serve a God who says that I can live an abundant life, so why am I drowning? Instead of following an irrelevant cheat sheet, I started studying real truth. And I can gladly tell you that since I finally stopped following every new trend of the world, I started to find the things only God can give me. Because of that, my life has been renewed. I would say that my life is new, but renew is a better word because I feel as though I am back to the original person God created me to be. I am not perfect and never will be, but I am free. And so I would like to answer the second question. No, it does not have to be this way. There is a God who says, seek and you will find. And I want to reassure you that when you start following him, you'll find him and so much more. I recently watched an interview of a person who escaped from North Korea. The interviewer was asking her why the people in her country had not tried to fight for freedom. And she said, how do you fight for freedom if you do not know that you're a slave? In a very different context, and obviously on a vastly different level, I could see how her wisdom applies to many areas. This is why many of us have not looked for an alternative to the things we're struggling with, because we don't even realize there's a struggle. We think, if everyone is like this, then this must be normal. I once heard Pastor Sean Smith say, there is a big difference between the word normal and the word typical. Let's say you go to the doctor feeling sick, and the doctor says, you have a cold. This is normal. If you are used to being healthy, this sickness is not normal. It may be typical, but it is not normal. In the same way, the things you are walking through may be typical, but they are not normal. Slowly, subtly, and in line with droves of others, we have allowed the world to shape so many facets of our lives and behaviors without stopping to realize how not normal some of them are. In some cases, we've shackled ourselves to ideals and influencers and these very typical lives we don't actually like. We seek and follow things that drain us instead of fill us. And we think it's normal, but it's not. A life of freedom is available, but there is only one way to get there. we have to trade in that cheat sheet and start searching for the truth. We have to let Jesus Christ be our guide. Who you are following is who is influencing you. Who or what you are investing your time in is who is influencing you. And that includes how you spend your time and your money, how you live out your relationships, how you determine what goals you are chasing or not chasing, and so much more. We're all trying to grow and build meaningful lives, but so often what we're building isn't meaningful. It's broken and not quite enough to satisfy or allow us to feel purposeful. With so much noise in the secular culture and how much we immerse ourselves in that culture, it's easy to feel lost. It's easy to search for the way forward, to latch on to someone, anyone, like who you wish you could be or who has a life you wish you had. It's easy to get lost following an idea of someone else's life, and then the next thing you know, you don't recognize the person in your own mirror. Trust me, the times I have followed the trends of the world too closely and changed my hair, makeup, clothes, and whatever else I could to model the look, thinking that is what I needed to feel confident, I always came up short. I look back at those seasons and I see a girl trying to convince herself that she actually was the stranger she was becoming. It's easy to get so busy modeling our lives after these influencers and influences that we waste precious energy. Our main focus gets far away from Jesus. Many times, although we may have a desire to look like Jesus, we end up looking more like the influencers on social media, the celebrities we watch on TV, or even the pastors at our church. Because the truth is, that is who we are really following. You may be asking, how can you, Sadie Rob Huff, with a social media following of millions and big speaking engagements, possibly scrutinize the very social media platforms that have given you an audience? Fair question. I've had to think about this myself. First, I am not bashing those platforms. I am grateful for them and believe they are an opportunity for good. But my goal is to make my platform about Jesus, not about me. If you are following me, I will always tell you that I am not leading you to me. That would offer you very little. I don't want you to try to be me. I want you to be the unique, whole, and wonderful person Jesus made you to be. I won't always get it exactly right, but I want to use my influence to lead you to Jesus. In Him, we can find peace, hope, joy, and contentment. In blindly following people, we too often find anxiety, comparison traps, and discontentment. I may be considered a leader, but I am first a follower. Jesus is the only leader and influencer worth following because He is the essence of all you are searching for. Once you put your energy into following Jesus and all that this entails, the good, the bad, and especially the challenging, you will feel the freedom to stop looking for all those other things. Worldly platforms and positions, the accumulation of things that aren't bringing you joy, superficial relationships that make you feel empty, those will pale in comparison to what you find in Jesus. So, my friends, the search is over, and you have found what you are looking for, but the journey has just begun. There's no shame here and no judgment. We're all on this journey in some way. Now, let's learn how to redirect our steps and follow Jesus above all. 1. Who is influencing you? Do you ever find yourself picking up your phone and immediately heading over to your Instagram app? I'm raising my hand over here. I can't begin to tell you how many times I've deleted that app from my phone. Sometimes I get in the habit of tapping, deleting, and downloading again. And repeat. I do this because I get tired of how I start to feel when I use social media too much. I get tired of the comparison. I get tired of the hateful comments. I get tired of feeling like I need to do more, buy more, post more, or look more like something I'm not. Have you ever felt this way? Together, we're going to kick some unhealthy habits to the curb. Social media can only be as healthy as we are. And yes, social media can be healthy. This journal is all about discovering who we are following and how we are influenced. We're going to take a personal inventory and become better followers and leaders, both on social media and off. Choose who you follow. If you're reading the book in this journal, you're interested in these questions. Who am I following? And why does it matter who we follow? We have to realize that who we are following is influencing our lives. I believe this is an important part of the process. Before we can be leaders, we have to be followers. In addition, we have to really know and pay attention to who we are following and what is influencing us. I want you to know that there is an ultimate influencer who we need to follow on a daily basis. We all get to choose who we follow, and we get to choose what we allow to lead our lives. I hear people complain that their social media is full of negative stuff. And yes, social media can be negative, but that also depends on who you are following and what you are allowing yourself to see. Life outside of our phones is the same. There are negative influences and things that will lead us in the wrong direction, just like there are positive influences that will lead us in a good direction.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.